How's it going, everybody? It's DanFromHali back with another reaction video for you today. If reactions to music and music videos are what you are into, you've come to the right channel because it's what I do 5 days a week, twice daily over those 5 days. And you can get notified every single time that I post new content just like this by hitting that pink and blue icon down that bottom right-hand corner of your screen. That's my subscription button. So I've been doing this thing, this little social experiment where I talk about the subscription button and its importance just to see if it has any kind of importance, if it changes anything for how people subscribe and view my videos here. And it might have a negative impact, it might not. If it does, well, I just won't do it anymore. Like I said, it's an experiment. So pressing the subscription button helps me as a creator. It also helps YouTube. As a creator, when I go and I do these videos and I look into if I want to do another song by another artist, if I want to do another reaction video for them, I have to look at, you know, how many people watched the last one, how many people did I convert from being a new viewer into a new subscriber. And once that number starts to dwindle down, it, to me, is a sign that people aren't watching these videos anymore and they're losing interest in them, so it's time to move on to something else, which may not always be the case. And I think that a lot of people don't realize how much power is in that subscription button. It's free to use. It gives me the motivation that I need to keep going with these. And I try to tailor make this channel for my viewers. I take a lot of requests. Most of what I react to is done by request. And you can do that by going down to the comments section. Comments, likes, subscription. It costs absolutely nothing to come by my channel. And pressing those buttons and engaging in this channel really helps drive me to do more for you. And for YouTube, it tells YouTube when you do these things that you want to see me pop up in recommended videos for other viewers just like yourself and to show up higher up in searches as well. So if you like what you see at the end of this, just go ahead, press that subscription button, and we can, if this isn't the kind of content that you want to see, go down to that comment section, let me know what you do want to see coming up, and I'll be more than happy to look into it for you. So I'm doing something today that I've never done before. I'm sitting down, I'm listening to Taylor Swift. Yep, that's right. I've never just sat there and listened to Taylor Swift. I think I might have heard her when I worked at the bar. I might have heard her in movies and stuff before, but I've never just listened to Taylor Swift. I don't even think I've been in a car and had a radio station on where Taylor Swift was playing. It's just, I don't like her. Or I don't think I like her music from what I know of. Isn't something that appeals to me. But it's time. So we're going to be reacting to The Best Day. It's a song off of her Fearless album, which received a re-release in April of this year. So we're going to be reacting to that. It's The Best Day, Taylor's version. And we're going to do it. We're going to do that right now. And who knows? We might be pleasantly surprised. Might not. But you never know unless you start, and you never start unless you start playing. If you don't start playing, you just don't get anywhere. So let's press play and let's get going. Oh, this is gonna be a cute video, isn't it? I'm a sucker for cute videos. Where's Waldo? I don't know what I was expecting from this. It's a great song, though, I think. I think I like it. Now, I'm not sure if I like the song or if I think I think the video is beautiful because the video is most definitely beautiful. And it's bringing me back a lot of nostalgia from when I was a kid, because a big part of my childhood was spent, you know, going around to, you know, hockey games and tournaments and spending weekends with my dad and all that kind of stuff. And it's bringing me back to that and all the comfort that that brought to me. So I don't know if I'm enjoying the song or if I'm just enjoying the nostalgia that the song and the video is bringing me. But the two could be interchangeable, I think, right? At the very least, what it says is I'm appreciating Taylor Swift, which is words that I never expected to come out of my mouth. But here we are. So she's about to say she's 13. I swear to God, if one of her parents dies by the end of this song, I'm going to be a teary mess. And I'm not ready for that. Please don't let that happen.
Princesses and pirate ships and the seven dwarfs. Daddy's smart and you're the prettiest lady in the whole wide world. Now I know why all the trees change in the fall. I know you were on my side even when I was wrong.
I was expecting, I don't know anything about Taylor Swift. I don't know if her parents are alive or not. And if one of those died, I'm already half teared up already. I was expecting it. But that was a really, really beautiful song. And again, I don't think I was expecting that. Most of what I know from Taylor Swift, what I have heard from working at the bar is some of her newer, poppier stuff. And I'm sure some of the stuff that I haven't heard that hasn't been overplayed. Like, I don't even think I could tell you the name of one of her songs. Because, and it's not just her. Most of the stuff that I heard while at work, I just kind of tune out because you hear the same song working at a bar about 12 times a night. I'm sure she has some decent stuff. It's never really been for me. I'm definitely not her demographic, I don't think. But out of all the songs I could have picked, I think this is probably the right one for me. I had no idea what it was about. I just kind of went through her videos and seen what was newer. Now, because this is Taylor Swift, there's a good chance that this might even be blocked. I might not even be able to react to this. Hopefully that's not the case, because I really enjoyed doing this. Parents are really important, and I thought that this was really sweet, a really nice way to tell her mom, tell her, well, I mean her parents, because she mentioned her dad a couple times there, how much they mean to her and how much their influence kind of, led to her upbringing and being the woman that she is today. And being able to use your fame and being able to use your platform and the medium that you excel in to deliver that message. I think that is just so sweet, because you hear artists talk up their fans and stuff like that all the time in music videos and whatnot. So it's nice to see when, and I know Taylor's not the first, but it's nice to see when they pay tribute and homage to the parents. Because where would we be without our family, right? For better or for worse. Yeah, that was really sweet. She has a nice voice. Will I react to her more? Who knows? I don't know. I think I need to react to some more contemporary pop artists and stuff like that. So this was me kind of trying to branch out into that uncharted waters that is contemporary musicians and contemporary pop. But guys, that's up to you. If you like this, if you want to see me react to some more Taylor Swift, you know what to do. We just talked about that earlier. If not, if this isn't what you want to see me react to, go down to that comment section. Tell me what you do want to see me react to. That way, I can take your request and I can run with it and see what I can do about getting more content that you want to see here on my channel. Until next time, guys, thank you very much for coming out to check out another one of my reaction videos. I love you as always. Dan from Hell Yeah.